स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू वर्चुअल क्लास ऑफ म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन ऑफ ग्रेटर मुंबई एजुकेशन डिपार्टमेंट. आई एम मिसेस अक्षता काले एंड टुडे वी विल लर्न मैथ्स. कम ऑन स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस मूव टू द चैप्टर.
सब्जेक्ट इज मैथ्स ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 4th एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज मेजरिंग टाइम. स्टूडेंट्स, we measure time with the help of instruments like clock and calendar, right? In our day to day life, each and everything depends on time, right? For example, school time, class time, lunch time, dinner time, play time, etc. In school also we run on timetable, right? Okay, if you reach school late one day, then teacher asks, why are you late today, isn't it? And if you reach home late, then your mother asks, why are you late? Means overall meaning is that we must have to follow the time and there is no choice. So isn't it good to learn to measure the time perfectly in its own language? Okay, then let us move to learn time language using clock. See this? This is a clock, you know, right? You have studied about this in standard 3rd also. That is, you have basic knowledge about the clock. Then also we will take a quick recap of this one. Now see this. Here we can see the three hands. What we call hands. Okay. This is called as our hand. See, this is a short one in length. And this is shortest one. You can say here our hand. Okay. This second one, it is called as minute hand. This is longer than the hour hand, right? This is called minute hand. And the third one, that is very thin, that is called as second hand. Got this, students? In clock there are three hands, or you can see two hands also, clock. Okay, hour hand and minute hand, and some watches they have second hand. Okay, now we have to give importance to the hour hand, which is the shortest one, and it is the minute hand. Okay, you have to give importance to these two, because while reading the time we give more importance to the hour hand and the minute hand. Okay, see this. This is a clock with two hands, isn't it? Please observe carefully here. This smaller one is called as hour hand. Okay, and this longer one is called as minute hand. Can you see the black one is hour hand? Okay, see this. When the white hand that moves full 360 degree, means when it takes one full round, then the smaller hand, that is our hand, changes its position to one digit. See, got this? Means 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. From 12 to 1 it is 5 minutes, isn't it? You know this. 12 to 1 it is 5 minutes, from 1 to 2 again 5 minutes, that is 10 minutes here. We always start counting the minutes from 12, isn't it? Here we start. This is 5 minutes, this is 10 minutes, this becomes 15 minutes, isn't it? Like this, total it is 60 minutes. So you know that 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. Okay? And 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. Now you can see here a second hand. See, this is a second hand. Got this, students? This is hour hand, this is minute hand, this is second hand. Here 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. When this second hand takes full one round, then this minute hand changes its position of one digit front. See here, we can write second hand means this hand moves very swiftly, very smoothly. Okay, the second is a very small unit used to measure time less than a minute. Got this, students? Very small unit is second, after that minute, after that hours. Okay, students, you can see here a clock. You can see two hands. One is on 7, that is smaller, and the longer is on 12. Now please try to read the time. Hour hand is smaller and minute hand is longer. Yes, you are right. This is 7 o'clock. Isn't it? In digits, how we write 7.00. This is 7 o'clock. Correct? Now read this. Here also you can see two hands. Smaller one is called hour hand, that is between 8 and 9. And the minute hand is on 6. That is a longer hand. Come on, dear students, read the time. Here we can say here 8:30. In our daily language, how we say 8:30, isn't it? Okay. Write the time shown in each clock in the box given below it. See, this is a clock. Right? Come on, tell me the time. Two hands. Hour hand is on 1 and minute hand is on 12. So it is 1 o'clock. How we say? 1 o'clock. Right? Good. See this. Both hands, they are overlapped. Both are on 12. Means exactly it is 12 noon. What we say? 12 noon. Not 12 o'clock. We say 12 noon. Okay? Next one. See this. Here numbers are not given. But you know that in watch or in clock, only numbers from 1 to 12 are written and the position is fixed. In any watch, the position of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12, the position is fixed. Okay, now come on, tell me here, what is the time? And here 12 and 6 are opposite to each other in every watch or clock. And 3 and 6 are opposite to each other. So this is, you are right, this is a 7 o'clock. What is the time here? 7 o'clock. After O, we use apostrophe sign and we write clock. Okay? Students, this is a digital clock. What we say? Digital clock. This shows only the digits. What is the real time? It tells us. Here you can see three parts of two digits each. Isn't it? We can see like these clocks on the railway stations, in the bus stands, or in the government offices, or in the private offices too. You may too have this in your house also. This is very easy to read. See, these first two digits, they tell us about the hours. Isn't it? And the middle two digits, they tell us about minutes. and the last two digits, they tell us about seconds. Now read the time. 12 hours 43 minutes 59 seconds. Right? Otherwise 12 hours 44 minutes and 0 seconds. This is called digital clock. Okay. Now we will come to our clock. Write the time shown by the clocks below in hours and minutes. Here, students, clocks are shown, and we have to read this, okay, by using dash hours, dash minutes. Like that, we have to mention about the minutes also and hours also. See this example. You can see here two hands in a clock, isn't it? Two hands, a green hand that shows us the hour, and the red colored hand, it tells us about the minute, isn't it? Now here, what is the time? 45 minutes past 1. Okay, because it is near to the 2, right? So it is coming near to 2 o'clock. So this is 45 minutes, 5 10 15, this is 20 25 30 35 40, now 45, isn't it? This is 45 minutes past 1. Okay, see this. Come on, tell me what is the time here. This is our hand, this is our hand, and this is minute hand. This, you know, 30 minutes, so this is 35 minutes past. The hour hand is between 2 and 3, means we are taking 3, right? Here 35 minutes past 2, right? 35 minutes past 2, because it is near to the 3, right? Next, see this, try to read, very easy. 15 minutes past, here it is between 10 and 11, so 10, isn't it? 15 minutes past 10. Next is, come on, tell me, this is 30 35 40, correct? 40 minutes past between 3 and 4, means 3, isn't it? 40 minutes past 3. Yes, students, this one, again two hands. Minute hand shows 10 minutes, correct? And the hour hand is indicating 7. So it is 10 minutes past 7. Isn't it? Next, see here, minute hand is on 55. We are going like this, isn't it? In this direction, that is called clockwise direction. Okay, where is the hour hand? Between 2 and 3. Very near to 3. Then also the time is 55 minutes past 2. Okay, next one is, see, this is 30 minutes. 35 minutes, this is 40 minutes. 40 minutes, and the hour hand is between 9 and 10. So it is 40 minutes past 9, isn't it? Next one. See, the hour hand is between 12 and 1, and the minute hand is on 25 minutes, because it is on 5. So what we can say, 25 minutes past 12, isn't it? Very good. You know how to read this in terms of minutes and hours, isn't it? Now read the time given in the box and draw the position of the clock hands. Here it is given in inverse position, means here we have to draw the hands. Okay, time is given in the box. Okay, now what is the time here? 15 minutes past 12, means 15 minutes means the minute hand should be on 3, isn't it? And past 12 means the hour hand should be between 12 and 1, isn't it? Okay, we will draw. First, we will draw this point, means the fulcrum. Then here, minute hand, 15 minutes it is showing. And this is hour hand between 12 and 1. Okay? See, this is 15 minutes past 12, isn't it? See, one more. 35 minutes past 8. See, 35 minutes means it should be on 7. Which hand? Minute hand. Yes, you are right. Minute hand should be on 7. And what about the hour hand? That is between 8 and 9, isn't it? Because past 8. So it is between 8 and 9. Right? Good. Next one. 10 minutes past 5. 10 minutes past 5 means, here 10 minutes means the minute hand should be on, yes, you are right, 2. Correct. And what about the hour hand? That is, yes, you are right, that should be between 5 and 6. Right? Okay, good. Next, 25 minutes past 4. 25 minutes means it should be on 5. Right? And what about this? Past 4. So the hour hand should be between 4 and 5. Yes, you are right. Very good, students. Using the terms a quarter past, half past, and a quarter to. Okay, dear students, this is a language of time. What is this? Time language, you can say. Okay, how there are different languages like this. Here, this is a time telling language. We will see this. Okay, these are new words for you. See this. 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. You know, na? Right? 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. Half an hour. Half of 60, how much? That is 30. Half of 6 is 3, isn't it? So, half of 60 is 30. So, half an hour means 30 minutes. Right? Then, quarter of an hour. Quarter means half of half. That is, half of 30 is 15 minutes. So, quarter of an hour is equal to 15 minutes. Got this? 3/4 of an hour. See, 3 times 15. That is equal to 15, 3s are 45. Got this? Means 3/4 of an hour is equal to 45 minutes. Okay, students? Now, see this. After 12 o'clock, we start. Students, we will learn now how to read the clock by using the clock language or time language. Okay? See this. These two hands, you are familiar with these two hands, isn't it? The red one, that is shorter one, is called hour hand, and the longer one, that is blue colored, it is called as minute hand, isn't it? The hour hand is near 12 and the minute hand is on 1. Means here when it is 12, we say o'clock, right? When both are on 12, then we say o'clock, 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, like that. When the minute hand is on 12, then we say o'clock, right? Now, when now it is on 1, means it is 5 past. How we read? 5 past 12, isn't it? Okay. When it moves to 2, then we say this is 10 past, isn't it? 10 past 12. Then when it moves to 3, then we say quarter past. We don't say 15 past. What we have to use? Quarter past 12. Okay? See this 12. Quarter past 12. Okay? When it moves to 4, then we have to read like 20 past. When it moves to 5, then it becomes 25 past. How we read? 25 minutes past 12. Okay. When it reaches 6, then what we have to read now? Here, half past 12. Got this, students? What to read? Half past 12. Okay. When it moves to 7, then we have to read 25 minutes 2. See here, we are not using past. Here we are using 25 to 1. Got this? 25 minutes to 1 o'clock. Then when it reaches 8, then we have to read, we have to lessen the 5 minutes. Okay, then it becomes 20 minutes to 1. See, dear students, this is the main difference from here, from 12 to 6. It is past. Okay, half past. And from 6 to 12, we are saying here 2. T-O-2. Here we use past. That is over. This is 2. Means it is there. Okay. So, okay, when it reaches 9. Okay, then what to tell? As quarter. Correct? Quarter 2. Quarter means 15 minutes. You know that 15 minutes left for 1. Got this, students? So, how to read? Quarter to 1. Okay. When it reaches 10, then what to say? 10 minutes to 1. 10 minutes to 1. Okay. When it reaches to 11, then we have to say 5 minutes to 1. Got this, students? 5 minutes to 1 o'clock. And when it reaches 12, this hour hand will be on 1. Correct? Then how we read? This is 1 o'clock. Got this, students? Here, this side on the, this is called clockwise direction. When the hour hand moves from 12 to 6, we have to use past word. Okay? And when it moves further, that is from 6 to 12, then we have to use word 2. Means that many minutes left. Okay? 2. For the students, this is called clock language. Quarter past, half past, quarter 2, and o'clock. Okay? Now, write the time shown by the clocks. Now here we have to read by using the time language. Now come on, dear students, this is the hour hand is between 12 and 1 and the minute hand is on 3. So this is quarter past 12. Very good. What is this? Quarter past 12. Next one. Yes, you are right. Quarter past 1. Very nice. Because 15 minutes is nothing but quarter past. Right? We will move. Now this is, please observe carefully. The hour hand is between 11 and 12 and the minute hand is on 9. Yes, you know that up to 6 we use past and from 6 to 12 we use 2. Very good. Quarter to 12. Nice answer. Next one. Yes. Again the minute hand is on 9. So that is quarter 2. and the hour hand is between 12 and 1. So good, it is 1:45. Yes, you are right. See the time here. Hour hand is between 1 and 2 and the minute hand is on 6. So this is 1:30. Very good. 1:30. Next one. Again the minute hand is on 6 and the hour hand is between 10 and 11. Then this is 10:30. Isn't it? 10:30. Write the time shown by the clock. See this? Now the minute hand is on 2, correct? This is 2, you know that, right? And the hour hand is between 10 and 11, isn't it? So what is the time here? Correct. 10:10. Right? 10:10. Next one. See this? Yes, you are right. 1:45. Correct. Next. 10:15. You are right. Which clock shows the time? 1:30. You can see here two clocks. Right? Both are having three hands. Hour hand, minute hand and the second hand. Now, we have to identify the clock which is showing 1:30. Now, you know the meaning of 1:30. Isn't it? Yes. Which one? Yes, you are right. This second clock that is showing 1:30. Because dear students, the hour hand is between 1 and 2. And the minute hand is on 6. Means that is 1:30. Isn't it? So this is the right one. And what about the first watch? First clock? Read the time. The hour hand is between 2 and 3. So that is 2:30. Isn't it? Okay. Here we have to read the clock which shows the time 5:30. See here, two clocks you can see. In the first one, two hands, three hands are there. In the second also, three hands we can see. And two hands are exactly same in both the clocks. That is second hand and the minute hand. Right? Only we have to give importance is to the hour hand. In the first one, it is between 5 and 6. And in the second clock, it is between 6 and 7. And we need the time 5:30. Yes, you are right. The first one is the correct answer. Yes, because the hour hand is between 5 and 6, isn't it? So in the first clock, it is showing 5:30. Right? And in the second clock, it is 6:30. Right? Okay. Now fill in the blanks. Okay. First one, 1:45. That is equal to -:00. See, you have to bring the clock in your mind. Think about the clock. 1:45. 2 means 15:01. Yes, you are right. Next one. 1:15. Past is there. 1:15. So, -:00. Yes, 1 means 15. 15 minutes past 1. Next, half past 3 means dash minutes past dash. Half means 30 minutes exactly. 30 minutes past 3. Right? Next, 15 minutes past 4. How we will say in the time language? Dash 4. Yes, dear students? Quarter past 4. Yes. Next, 45 minutes past 10. See, 45 minutes past 10. How to write here? Yes, very good. Quarter to 11. Quarter to 11. Very good. Last one. 30 minutes past 6. What to write here? Yes, you are right. Half past 6. Very good. Nice, students. Now, students, this is all about the reading clock. Okay. Now, in the next lecture, we will read calendar. Okay. We will learn how to read calendar. Okay.
Thank you very much for being a part of this lesson. Please subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to get the new updated videos.